and welcome to Beer Goggles Reviews with me, Terry Kay. Now, as you know, I've had a bit of a trip to Norfolk. Been around a few different breweries. Didn't get to see these boys, very unfortunately. I didn't get to see this brewery. Which is a bit disappointing because they do some fine beers. This is one of them. Well, I don't know, I haven't tried it, but this one, the 1992 Champion Beer of Britain, Canberra's Champion Beer of Britain, that's the campaign for Real Ale, Canberra. Also, the one that I reviewed the other day, their Woodford Wherry, was also Champion Beer of Britain in 96. Now, that is quite an accolade. That's quite a thing, because there's only one other brewery, and that's the massive and brilliant Fuller's, that have got two Champion Beer of Britain, or Britain's Champion Beers of Britain, I suppose it is. So let's turn this telly off, because it's putting me off. I keep looking up like that. So they're the only other brewer in Britain that have done that. Quite amazing. Right, so. And Woodford's is not a big, great big thing like Fuller's, you know. They do alright, they're not bad, you know, they're not a little microbrewery, but they're not a massive one, you know. So, let's go for this, bottle conditioned, Real Ale. I'm going to show you the front and do the up and down the bottle like I do. There you go, dubbity bibbity bibbity boo, read. You just read it in your own time, you know. It's nice like that. Saves me reading it to you, you know. Now, plain top, plain crown. Not plain anymore because I've got a couple of scratches on it. Which will go up there and will go in my collection. Now, straight off the bottle, let's have a sniff. Nice kind of chocolatey and biscuity sort of notes, a little bit of licorice in there. I shall tell you how it smells in a minute. Now, where it's dark, and also it's a brown bottle, it's very difficult to see if there's any floating yeast or anything, so, especially in poor light and stuff, you know. So I'm kind of just having to pour it in, and I'm going to pour it halfway. I think we might need the torch for this, because it's dark. So let's shine the torch through, see what sort of colours we get. Let me have a look first. Oh, slight ruby to it. Oh, there you go, that sort of colour. Slight ruby there to it. I can't go without doing that now. I'll do it one day and people go, you didn't do the whoa. We got any barflies yet? I'm waiting for them. It's usually about 5 minutes in. Oh wow, that's lovely. For 4.6, it smells a lot, quite a bit higher, you know. It smells quite beefy, you know. It smells malty. It smells toffee, it smells a little bit of coffee and that, and lovely lush chocolates and that. Kind of nice, expensive chocolate. I think there's something else in there. A little bit of distant orange, like a kind of, I think Terry's chocolate orange, I think they do a dark chocolate version. And a little bit like that, like a hint of orange in there as well. Right, well let's dive in. Oh. Oh, that is nice. That is nice. What do they call this? Norfolk Nog. Old Dark Owl, yeah. It's kind of got that. I think they used to call it stale ale. and used to get the like the different barrels. You'd have a little bit of stale, half of stale, and then half of something else, you know. And some places still do it. There's not many, but there's some places still do it. And you kind of have a little bit of the one that's been sitting there for ages in the barrel and it, and one that's kind of new in it, and it's got a little bit of that to it. Oh, that's glorious. Beer oozies. That's a lovely word, isn't it? Oozies, dark and sweet roast malt flavours. Hints of chocolate, treacle and licorice. That was what I was looking for, licorice. Did I say that? I think I did, didn't I? Of course, that is really, really lovely. There's all sorts of lovely little dark, those kind of lovely dark dark flavours and aromas and everything. Really lovely. You're getting something clinical in there as well. Not chemical, but kind of clinical almost. Really clean and almost not antiseptic. I don't know how to explain it. Kind of like a little bit like tea tree oil. A tiny bit like that, as if there's a tiny bit of tea tree oil in there as well. Most people won't know what the bloody hell I'm on about. Anyone that's kind of into aromatherapy a little bit or anything like that, they will know and will have smelt tea tree oil, you know. But it's nice. Cloves, fennels, licorice, all sorts of those dark notes in there as well. Oh, I'm going to go in for a bit more. That's lovely. It goes down absolutely spotless. Right straight down the old gullet it goes. Now, I'm looking to see what we've got sediment-wise. There is, I don't know if you can see this. I'm trying to hold it in the neck here. Where's my little... Now I've got to try and do all sorts here. I don't know, I can't even see you here. Yeah, can you see that? That is what you hold in behind the neck there, that. Where are we? All tight. I think we've lost him now. Him there somewhere, is he in? I'm sure we see him a minute ago. Yeah, him there, look. Little bits and bobs and stuff like that. Now that's what that shoulder's for. You can hold that last little bit, and then that, you hardly end up with any waste. Yeah? Down here, you'll see a little bit of the hazing on the bottom of the glass and that there. Kind of sticks to the window. It's all good stuff. But in something like that, you won't see it. And I don't think you'll see it anyway. Back with the torch again. It's slightly cloudy. It's like a car with the headlights in the fog a little bit. Now, the fog, the hazing, it doesn't do you any harm. Some people go, oh, it makes you poo and things like that. I've never had that. You know, I don't know. I don't think it does. I'm sure there's no medical evidence on that. I don't know. Might be just kind of psychosomatic and that. I don't know. But if people say it does. You know, it makes them go. But is that a bad thing? Is it? You know, I don't know. Clear the system through and that. It ain't as if you could... like, you know, chewing on the toilet seat and praying for a lump and stop it. Right, anyway, finishing off, that is a glorious drink, without a doubt. Go and buy that and try it. That is an absolute glorious drink. That is Norfolk Nog. Not sure what a Norfolk Nog is. Does it say? But that is a Norfolk Nog, and it is bloody delicious, so go and buy it and try it. Okay, bye!